be sure to check out my Veve and Omi Investors Group in the description down below. Together, we build generational wealth and go over everything you need to be profitable in the Veve markets. Yo, what is going on, y'all? I'm Cavell Anderson, and we are back with another Veve and Ecomi video, homies. In this one, we're going to be talking about an interesting topic. Of course, we've touched on a lot of topics lately over the last few days, and today we're definitely going to have to get into probably the biggest one that I see around the community, which is the whole bots thing. The bots and people's concerns surrounding bots and how they're taking over the Veve app, how they're taking over the market, taking over drops. I'm going to start off saying the same thing that I always say when it comes down to bots. Before we jump into it, be sure to drop that thumbs up, subscribe, turn on notifications so you stay updated with everything going on. And yeah, let's just get into it. So my logic surrounding bots is very, very simple. If you go for a drop, realize there are millions of people on this platform and you never know how many people are going for the same drop. And then there's a lower amount of additions. So if your whole strategy to Veve is going for drops, yes, that feeling is amazing. When you hit a drop, it's no feeling like it. It's a great experience. It's fun. It's something that you can do with your people. But at the same time, it's supposed to be one of those things where you do it, but you don't actually expect to win. It's like playing the lottery. You have fun playing the lottery, but you don't expect to actually win. It's just, you're hoping that you win, but you just don't expect to. We're no longer in the days early on in the project where it was only 60,000 of us. It was 60,000 of us going for 30,000 additions. And then all 60,000 people weren't on. It was only maybe 10, 20,000 of us going for it. So we had 60,000 people on the app, 10 or 20,000 of us going for it. Of course, you had people out here grabbing nine and 10 of these on the drop. But what happens the later, the more time goes by, the more people actually get on the app and the harder that it is. And when I say more people get on the app, that does mean more people with malicious intent out here looking for ways to cheat the app. And sadly, some of those guys figure things out until they get caught by Veve. They figure things out and it just goes that way. Then when it comes down to the marketplace as well, people are upset that when things get listed, it's looking like a lot of bots are controlling the floors as well. My only concern and my only question about this stuff is people seem to be backwards investing. I've talked about this a little bit in another video, but I don't understand why people are so bent on getting the new drop to the point where you're trying to go to the secondary market, buy it from bots. I mean, if it's a price that you're willing to pay, then by all means, buy it. But usually if the bots are priced, the bots are going to do one of two things. The bots are going to price the item really, really good or really, really bad. So because the bot don't actually care how much this thing is worth, they're going to maybe price it too low, or they're going to price it too high to where it has no choice but to come down. You need to understand what you're trying to buy so you can understand how valuable it is and which direction the market is going to move when it comes down to this item. You need to know if a bot is giving you a deal, because yes, these bots can sometimes give you deals. And that's what people are sleeping on as well, because if, let's say it's a really, really valuable collectible and a bot's just throwing it out here for any number just to recoup and make a little bit of a profit. The bot isn't going to care that this is a valuable collectible. They're just trying to get some money and keep it pushing. But you, like real people, let's say all real people who are educated got this drop. Now a real person knows how valuable this is. So everybody's going to be pricing it insane from the start. That's what we see a lot of times with some of the Disney drops. They get priced insane from the start because everyone knows how valuable it is. So the bots are the ones pricing reasonable in certain situations. But at the same time, one thing that people forget when you see a drop is that the newer stuff is always going to be less valuable than the older stuff. Season 1, season 2, the first time this stuff, like the first time certain things was released from brands and things like that, that is the stuff that's valuable. So I find it strange that people are out here because of like making such a big deal about bots when honestly, going for a new drop as it's still a new drop is really not a smart way to invest, to be honest. It's not a smart way to invest. It is a fun experience. And obviously, you need people buying this stuff. You need, like, the drops is doing well, and that's great. People who have nothing and who can actually secure a drop, that's amazing to be able to buy it for those prices. But if you can't, like, if you can't buy it initially for those prices, regardless of the reason, because I mean, crying about the, like, if it was all real people who got it or all bots who got it, it doesn't really matter. You didn't get it. So, I mean, what's the actual complaint about? Like, what's the actual complaint about? Yeah, you want to get it, but even still, let's say bots are completely out of the picture. What are your odds of getting drops when you have 3 million people on this platform anyway? What are your odds of you consistently hitting these drops? What are your odds? Like, let's say it's no bots whatsoever. So anytime something is in a marketplace, like if it was no bots whatsoever, when something gets put on a secondary market and it's a low price, then you have to wonder, why are they listening to this? This is a real person. You know for a fact it's a real person. So why would they be listening to this low? Is it really this unvaluable? Or is going to be priced way too high to where most people are not going to be able to afford it anyway. So you have to realize what happens when there is no bots, or what would be the best case scenario with no bots. And you have to make decisions accordingly. The fact of the matter is, when something is new, it's going to be driven by hype. You don't know what it's going to be worth. You don't know where it's going to settle at. But you do know that the newer things probably has a very much higher chance of dipping down at some point. Now, if it's some type of grail that comes out, then of course, go for that on drops, try to get that as low as possible. Yeah, grails, yeah, I mean, people are gonna price those ridiculously to where they will never be in reach if it's a grail of that caliber. But the fact of the matter is, most of these drops, when they first come out, it's all built around hype. And yeah, I know everybody wants an easy come up, but you don't always need an easy come up. You just educate yourself and grab some, like before I grab, like, so, if something comes out for $60, yet the Deadpool comic, I always go back to this comic. This is one of my favorite ones to hold. I have, like, if something comes out for $60 and I have a choice of getting something new for $60 or grabbing the Deadpool comic, two of those, $30 each, grab two Deadpool comics, I'm grabbing the Deadpool comics. It's just my mindset. Like, I'm okay being patient and letting those appreciate in value, because I know the value of those things, and they're old, they're older. A lot of people feel like they need to take part in every drop. They need to be in on everything new. And it's part of the community. It's the fun thing to talk about, the fun thing to do. It's something that we all come together as a family and we can enjoy these drops. We can enjoy these moments. And I know a lot of people are upset because it's like that vibe is changing. When you got more people coming on the app, barely people that you know are getting it anymore, then you have bots ruining the experience. I get how frustrating that can be. That is an experience, that is a vibe. But at the end of the day, it should just be an experience and it should just be a vibe. If something ruined the vibe, it shouldn't be the end of the world to you. It shouldn't be something you complain about for days. Like, the vibe was killed, bro. If I'm going to play basketball, and we playing the game, we having fun, I'm with my homies, it's the first time we met up in like a month and we went to hoop, then a fight break out, so now everybody gotta go. Yeah, they killed the vibe, but I mean, we just finna go do something else. We gonna go do something else. Like, they killed the vibe already, but we not just finna sit here and complain about it. Like, anytime we at a basketball court, what the heck? Yeah, like, I got my alarm set for the VV drops. You know, you can't miss those VV drops. Listen, I be talking all this trash, and then I'm like, yeah, I got the alarm set. Nah, I'm saying. But honestly, I pick and choose which drops I go for. I really don't go for a lot of drops. I just do always have the alarm set because, I mean, you never know. But I don't believe that there's a drop today. So, yeah, I don't know. I don't be knowing. Like, I'll be dead serious. Y'all think I be playing. But, yeah, like I said, if you with your homies, like, they kill the vibe. Every time we play basketball moving forward, we not finna sit here and complain in every single basketball court. Yo, they killed the vibe that one day. They like, nah, bro, we moved on to something different. We still have fun with the remainder of our day. And I mean, we moved forward. We kept it pushing. So many people get caught on this whole bots thing. If they're here, they're here. If they're not, they're not. It doesn't matter. The only thing that matters is, did you or did you not get the drop? If you didn't get the drop, what's the next best decision that you can make? Do you want to hold your liquidity? You want to hold your gems and keep liquidity? Or do you want to put it in an asset that could potentially appreciate in the future? Like, you decide, like, you can decide these things. Like, a lot, it's so many collectibles right now that's very cheap, undervalued, and they're all grails. Like, and it's so many grails that's undervalued right now. But people, it's like, you got to stop getting lost in the trap of, oh, this is a new shiny object in front of me. Let me get lost in this and let me sell all my old stuff, my old valuable stuff. Let me sell my antiques for this new stuff that just came out that we don't even know how it's going to perform. Because what you have to understand, every new drop that comes out is a new risk. That's a new risky investment because you don't know how this is going to perform. You don't know if it's going to be respected. You don't know if it's ever going to go anywhere. We have old grails that's already respected in real life. Grails that's already respected on VV. We have real grails. Like, so when it comes down, like certain drops, I get it. Like the this Aston Martin that came out. Okay, like that's a big deal. So I get how that can be a frustrating one to miss. And then some of those may be out of reach for some people. I get it. But at the same time, yo, you have to just, that's the game. That's the game, man. That really is the game. Of course, everyone would love to buy these things at the price that they come out at, but it's not always in the cards, and it's never going to be in the cards for everyone. There's not enough editions. There's never going to be enough editions of these. These are collector's items. This isn't just a... You wouldn't want it so bad if this was something that every single person was going to get, or anywhere near every single person was going to get. There's thousands of editions with millions of people interested. So I think that people need to learn and really focus on maneuvering the market, even with the bots. Let's say the bots are controlling the floors. You need to learn how to maneuver around these bots, because the fact of the matter is, right now is still the best opportunity that you're going to have to learn how to use the market. Like, learn how to use the secondary market. Like, there's no better opportunities than the opportunities you're going to find in the secondary market. So you can learn to maneuver your way around the bots, or you can try to wait for VV to be perfect. But then by the time they able to really control the bots a lot better, or really minimize bots to the lowest possible lowest possible amount of bots, by that time you're going to wait till like 5-10 million people are now on the app. So now, even though there's a hell of a lot less bots, you're not going to feel any difference, because we're going to go from less bots to more real people. The more that they lock down the bots, the more real people are joining the app. So, I mean, that's what it is. All these freaking notifications, but that's what it is, man. I'm gonna end the video here, y'all. Let me know what y'all think in the comment section down below. I just wanted to cover this topic because I know bots is still a big deal in the community. I just wanted to share some perspective with you all. Like, when there's a drop, if I don't get a drop, and I still just want to spend my gems, I'll just buy a grail. Like, there's no need to be fighting over something that's new, because that's a gamble. That's, anytime I go for a drop, I'm gambling. I'm aware that I'm gambling. I don't know if this is going to be valuable. I don't know what I'm going to get. It's a gamble for me. But anytime I go for a grail, I know what I'm doing. I'm like, okay, I'm holding this for the long term. This is going to be valuable in the future. I'm going to just hold it and chill. And it's a lot less stressful than even wondering if a new drop is ever going to be valuable, or trying to profit off of this short-term hype. You don't have to depend on profiting off short-term hype if you learn how to make money in the long term. But that's just my perspective. Let me know what you all think in the comment section down below. Be sure to drop that thumbs up, subscribe, turn on notifications so you stay updated. And yeah, I'm going to catch y'all on the next one. Peace out, y'all.